Every parcel has neighbors, and this is how to deal with them, according to Tony LaPrat. I hope you guys enjoyed this snippet from the Exodus podcast. Here we go.
What are the neighbors like where you're at? Because I'm so
they hate
sure
me.
Do they? So
that's the best way to tell if you're a good deer hunter.
Uh-huh.
If your neighbors like you, you ain't that great. Okay? Because it's honest. It's just it's like
jealousy
that in
thing.
Everything. It's yeah. just I've killed big bucks forever. Since
but
I,
aren't they trying to mimic and like
well,
copy
you would
some
think,
of the things
now, there
that you're
is
doing?
A couple of them that try to come to my boot camp, and I won't let them. I mean, yeah, I turn people down all the time. The point I'm getting at, most of them, if somebody was beating you all the time, instead of hating them, I'd want to go down and just talk to them. And anyone that talks to me for a few minutes realizes that I think outside the box and I have a lot of great information. They won't give me the time of day.
So let's say this. I'm your new neighbor, Tony, and I'm going to set up right on the fence line.
Yep.
What do you
well,
what do
that's you, what I show at my boot camps. I have a whole strategy to keep deer away from a property line. And I can control where a deer beds and where he can't bed. I can control which way he looks. People think it's hard. It's not even hard. So you can make deer do things that nobody even realized. That is my thing. Anything I figure out, I can use it two ways. I can use it to make my life easier, and I can make it harder for someone else to shoot my deer because I can control. So a lot of guys would think, just I'm going to give a basic thing. A lot of guys have a property, and they'll go, Tony, my neighbor's got a stand right there. So I don't want nothing done over here. I'd like to keep all our bedding on the other end. And I said, no, we want to put the bedding area right here. Well, he hunts right there. And I said, yeah, how's he going to get in it when they're here all day? The best thing to do is put beds right underneath a stand and make them all watch how he comes and goes. He can't come and go. And a few times they're going to learn that he's coming. They're going to study the predator. And now they know where he's at. Now he can't kill him. If they're bedding over here and they can't see him get in, they'll walk right into his trap. So I don't want food. I don't want scrapes. I don't want stuff like that over by him. But actually, I can make beds, make it hard for him to ever get a shot that direction. But I can cut the brush and make holes, and I'll make them so when they're laying in their beds, because I get in there, yeah, that's his stand. He cannot get near that without them seeing him. I build the doe beds along his travel route so they're underneath the brush, and they watch him try to walk in. Now they get a bus. I control what way they exit the thing. And what I just did is made his life miserable. I've been doing it forever. That's why the neighbors, they know I hold the deer. They just don't understand how to get them off my property.
So in that scenario where you're laying those beds out underneath someone else's stand based on their access routes to help protect them, are you specifically laying up another bedding area for those deer to go to that is more advantageous for you?
Yes, and then just like my neighbors, they want to, you know, people want to drive four-wheelers down the property line. They want to walk. They know you got all the things. All they want to do is walk down that line. They own all these other woods, but you hardly ever see them over by them. Why? They know the deer on my place. So what they want to do is line up. So now what I got to do is get the deer first part of the season when they come, I want them to see him coming and going, so now they go, we got a problem here. And then I give them another bedding area back farther that they can fall in. And deer are notorious to set on close to edges because they know that's where the predators come from. Dogs, coyote, man, walk edges. So you give them an edge, and they'll utilize it until they don't think they're safe no more, and now I can move them in the interior. The point is now they don't want to go that way in the evening. Instead of going that way, they turn and come towards me.
How often do your neighbors peel off a buck that you have, a target buck that you have?
To be honest with you, the guys that live on my section, they don't ever kill a quality buck. They'll kill some immature bucks, but they don't get the big guys.